This rule I just told you, all right, is one of the complicated thing in ITS, and many students have asked this doubt, sir, rule number 42 is not clear. Explain us. Please understand how this process goes, and then you will understand this particular rule. Rule number 42 is apportionment of eligible credit as well as ineligible credit. Eligible versus ineligible. So what will happen toward the month end? See, accountant does not have this much brain. Okay, that he will take call that what is eligible and what is ineligible. As a chartered, you and me finding it difficult to understand what is eligible ITC and what is ineligible ITC. You understand? So what accountants will do in normal organization, whatever purchases he has done in that month, okay, before filing GST return, he will bring this kind of bills to me. Alright, like you guys, tomorrow you are articles, so tomorrow you will go and handle that particular thing. He'll say, sahab, itna sa purchase kiya hai, sabka credit le lo kya? This kind of question he will ask, alright? Then you will cross, like you will start checking these particular bills, alright? You will start checking this particular bill. I'm just putting randomly. I had put these bills randomly in my hand. I got first bill, alright? This first bill has, okay, this first bill is about motor vehicle. This first bill is of motor vehicle. Now you tell me, motor vehicle allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Why? Because it is given in section 17, subsection 5, block of credit. You understand? So the moment you see, you will write this is block. This is? Block under section 17 subsection 5. Technically here in this rule we call it T3. T3 just like in accounts, you know, like in mathematics you used to give some variables to some certain items like x equal to this. Let us assume x is this. Yes. So here they have given T1, T2, T3, T4, C1, C2, C this like. You understand? So they have used this abbreviation. Do you understand what is T3? Yes. T3 is a block credit. So is it allowed or not allowed? Yes. Not allowed. So what will you do after out of total bill that he has given you, he will remove this bill. Beta, iska credit nahi lena. Okay? Do not take credit of this. Then I got one another bill. Another bill is this. This bill I told you, na? This blue marker. Do you remember my blue marker? Yes. This is exempted. This is a plastic that I purchased. This plastic, blue. Alright, what is the use of blue? Exclusively in exempted. Exclusively in?
Exempted.
Exempted. Exclusively in exempted if I am putting, then will I get credit of this? No. So I will write T2. Why? Because this is going to be used in? Hello, this is going to be used in? Exclusively exempted. So will I be eligible to take this credit? No. So not eligible. Again not eligible. Alright. Then I got another bill in my hand. Alright. This bill is of that laptop, you know, a partnership firm purchased 5 laptops. Yes. One laptop was used by son of a partner.
Yes.
That means you use for non-business purpose.
Yes.
Or your personal purpose.
Yes.
Alright, will you give credit?
No.
Alright, or this is a demat bill. You understand, demat bill, or this is a big bazaar bill. These products are sir, personal consumption products, non-business product. You understand? We will not give you credit of this. This is T1. Hello? What is T2? Exemption. Exclusively used in exempted supply. T1 is used exclusively for non-business purpose. Use, but for
none.
We get ITC of goods which are used in business or furtherance of business. These goods are used for non-business purpose. Am I clear? So will I get credit of T1, T2, T3?
No.
I will not get credit of T1, T2 and T3. You understand this part at least? I will not get credit of T1, T2 and T3. Now balance bills. These are the balance bills. You understand? Balance bills are eligible or ineligible? Tell me. What I removed up to now? Eligible. Eligible or ineligible? Balance. Which I removed? Ineligible. Then balance bills are eligible. This is C1. This is?
C1.
Sorry, this is T. This is not C1. This is T. Aha. This is C1. And what is T? T is a total bill. T is a?
Total
bill. From total bill, if I remove T1, T2, T3, what is left?
C1.
You understand? What is left? C1. C1 is eligible. You understand? Again, I am repeating. What is T1? Non-business. Come on, tell me. What is T1?
Non-business.
What is T2? What is T2? Exempted. And what is T3?
Block
credit. That means these three bills are ineligible. I removed it. So what is balance? C1. How C1 we have determined? From total, T1, T2, T3. You remove. The balance is? C1. You understand? That means I can claim credit on this. I have right to claim credit on this. Alright? Now out of this, where is my black marker? Alright? This bill, the next bill is of that black plastic, this black plastic. What is this black plastic? Exclusively taxable. Is it common? No, this is exclusively taxable commodity. If it is exclusively taxable, will I get credit on that?
Yes.
Achha, how much percent? 100%? Less than 100%? 100%. So, sir, I will remove T4 also. I will remove
T4.
So, what is T4? T4 is, please understand, T4 is credit attributable to. Credit?
Attributable
to inputs and input service used exclusively in taxable supply, including zero rated supply. So that red marker was exported. So taxable and zero rate. So this is exclusively available. Am I clear? I will remove this one also. But the purpose of removing this one is not ineligibility. It is 100% eligibility. Pura milega. तो इसमें से ये भी निकाल लिया तो अभी तक मैंने टी में से क्या क्या निकाला टी में से वॉट एवर आई हैव रिमूव्ड T1 T2 T3 दैट इज C1 फ्रॉम C1 आई रिमूव्ड T4 देन वॉट इज द लेफ्ट इज C2 लुक एट द फॉर्मूला ऑफ C2 C2 इज C1 माइनस T4 दैट मीन्स ऑल दिस बिल्स आर कॉमन बिल ऑल दिस बिल्स आर सर ये क्या है ये ब्लैक ये वाला जो व्हाइट वाला पार्ट है ना प्लास्टिक ये वो है मतलब ये कहां कहां पे यूज हुआ है सर ये टैक्सेबल में भी यूज हुआ है और ये एग्जम्प्टेड में भी यूज हुआ है और ये नॉन बिजनेस में भी यूज हुआ है कुछ घर पे भी लेकर गया मार्कर दिस हैज बीन यूज इन ऑल बिल्स यू अंडरस्टैंड सो ऑल दिस बिल्स आर बिल्स ऑफ C2 व्हाट इज C2 कॉमन इनपुट्स एंड कॉमन इनपुट सर्विसेज अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट विच कम्स टू माय फैक्ट्री टेल मी ही विल डू ओनली ऑडिट ऑफ टैक्सेबल कमोडिटीज और ऑल कमोडिटीज ही सर्विस इज कॉमन सर्विस फैक्ट्री रेंट टाइम पेइंग इज इट अ कॉमन or uncommon common for all product you understand marketing my branding the company which is doing branding will it do branding only of taxable commodity taxable marker or all marker that means all these services are common you understand this plastic is common hello yeah and that's why all these bills of either services C2 you understand or common goods or common services Common goods or common services. Why common, sir? Because it has been used in all types of product. What are all types of product? Taxable, exempted, exported, non-used for business purpose, distributed as a free sample, whatever purpose it is. You understand? That white plastic is used everywhere. You understand? Now we need to apportion this. Hello. In what ratio we have to apportion it? How much we use in taxable and how much we use in exempted? Whatever you use in taxable, you are eligible to claim that. Whatever you use in exempted, you are ineligible to claim that. Say for example, in this month, I sold only this marker. That means 100% exempted. Will I get credit of this? No, because 100% common goods also you are using in exempted. Acha, in this month, I had manufactured 100% taxable and exported. I will get 100% common credit. Acha, I had manufactured 70% taxable and 30% exempted. Yes, now you tell me 30% ineligible, 70% eligible. Okay? Itna easy a formula. Okay? But how they had given it, come on. Can you reach up to C2 mentally?
Yes.
Alright? From total credit, from total bills, we will first identify T1. What is T1? Non-business. What is T2? Exclusively exempt. What is T3? Block credit. So from T, we will remove T1, T2, T3. You will get C1. From C1, you will remove T4, which is exclusively using taxable. That means C2 is equal to C1 minus T4, which is a common credit. Hello? Now that common credit, we have to distribute between no taxable and exempted. How are we allocating it? Sir, D1, hello, that particular D1, how D1 is calculated? E upon F, C2 multiplied by E upon F, hello, C2, that common credit multiplied by E upon F, E is exempted turnover divided by total turnover. Hello, exempted turnover, out of 1000 crore turnover, 300 crore turnover is exempted and 700 crore is taxable. So what is my common sense that how much plastic I had used in exempted? So 300 crore out of 1000 crore, that means 30% out of 100%. You understand? So common credit of common credit of, say for example, 10,000. You will not get up to 30%. So what is D1? D1 is simple. D1 is common credit multiplied by exempt turnover. Forget about this abbreviation. What is in normal human language? D1 is equal to common credit multiplied by exempt turnover divided by total turnover. Is it difficult?
No.
You understand? So D1 formula is very easy. D1 is equal to E upon F multiplied by C2. Alright, what is E? Exempted turnover. What is F?
Total
turnover. What is C2? Common credit. Now you tell me, if you are an ice cream manufacturer, no doubt you will take ice cream to your house. But to what extent? 50% leke jayega? 10%? No, hardly sometime you will take that particular to your house. So maximum government say, maximum you will use goods for non-business purpose. Whatever goods you are manufacturing, you will use for non-business purpose to the extent of 5%. Tumko samajh rahe 5% kya hai? Achha, exempted ka to turnover hoga books of accounts mein. Why it will be there? Because exempted, even if it is exempted, you are selling it. So we will have turnover of exempted. But goods that you are using for non-business purpose, we may not have record for that. It may not be in your turnover calculation. It may not be forming part of your total turnover. So what government had determined? D2. What is the D2? Credit attributable to non-business purpose if common credit is used partly for business and partly for non-business purpose. You understand? And how they determine it? D2 is equal to C2 multiplied by 5%. Some standard number. 5% is standard deduction. Non-business ke liye use kiya, 5% standard minus kar denge. Because we don't have record for that. We don't have turnover for that. Agar turnover hota to hum log compare karte hain. Like exempted turnover. But good that you have taken to your house may not be having turnover. And this is a problem. How government has identified that problem and solved it? Simply sir, jo bhi common credit hai uska 5% maan lo ki personal ke liye use kiya hoga. Utna remove kar lena. So total how much we have to remove? We have to remove two parts. Which two parts sir? D1 and D2. Why D1 we are removing? Because utna exempted mein use hua. Why D2 we are removing? Because utna non-business ke liye use hua. Common non-business ke liye. Common exempted mein, common non-business mein. Matlab abhi jo baj gaya common. Hello. Isme ka jo baj gaya. You understand? Wo eligible hai, ineligible hai?
Eligible
hai. Alright. So what is D1? D1 isme ka. Hello. D1. This common mein ka. This is C2. इसमें का exempted turnover divided by total turnover D1. What is D2? इसका total multiply by 5% is D2. Alright, so D1 plus D2 you remove from C2. You remove from C2. C2 is a common credit. इसमें से D1 और D2 निकाल दो. D1 exempted, D2 non-business. जो बच गया वो C3. जो बच गया वो
C3.
तो C3 का credit लेगा कि नहीं लेगा? लेना पड़ेगा. Eligible ITC. You understand? This is eligible. Now you tell me, please think about it. You tell me total eligibility was only C3 or something else? Total. I need everybody to write here total eligible credit. Total eligible credit. Tell me total eligible credit. Khali C3 milega kya mujhe? Nahi. Aur ek mujhe milega upar se. Socho na. T4 bhi to milega kyunki T4 to 100% hai. तो कॉमन और 100% टैक्सेबल है तो मिलेगा ही. तो मुझे एक बात बताओ, टोटल इन एलिजिबल में क्या क्या आएगा? लोग बोलते हैं खाली D1 प्लस D2, ऐसा है क्या? नहीं, D1 D2 तो इन एलिजिबल है बिकॉज दैट इज कॉमन इन एलिजिबल. दिस इज कॉमन. अरे उसके अलावा एक्सक्लूसिवली वाला भी तो था. दैट इज T1 प्लस T2 प्लस T3. फिर से मुझे बताओ T1 में क्या था? एक्सक्लूसिवली इन नॉन बिजनेस. व्हाट वाज T2? एक्सक्लूसिवली इन एग्जेम्प्टेड. व्हाट वाज T3? ब्लॉक क्रेडिट. व्हाट इज D1? कॉमन क्रेडिट इन एग्जेम्प्टेड गुड्स. हेलो. व्हाट इज D2? कॉमन क्रेडिट इन नॉन बिजनेस गुड्स. इतना इन एलिजिबल है और इतना एलिजिबल है. अंडरस्टूड सर? जो इन एलिजिबल, जो कॉमन है ना, देखो जो इन एलिजिबल है उसका तो क्रेडिट लूंगा ही नहीं मैं. आई विल नॉट टेक. ये तो इन एलिजिबल है ना, ये तो बाहर निकाल दिया. लेकिन जो कॉमन है उसका तो पूरा लेना पड़ेगा ना, इनवॉइस में जितना भी लिखा है. आई विल क्लेम क्रेडिट फर्स्ट. स्टेप वन यू क्लेम 100%. स्टेप वन यू क्लेम 100%. स्टेप टू इन एलिजिबल. नो D1 D2 इसमें का D1 D2 इन एलिजिबल है. दैट मच यू ऐड टू योर आउटपुट टैक्स लाइबिलिटी. हेलो. अगर अमाउंट में बात करते, इफ दिस वॉज 10,000 एंड आउट ऑफ 10,000 4,000 इज इन एलिजिबल. D1 D2 का टोटल कितना है? 4,000. सो यू बुक 10,000 एंड देन यू रिवर्स 4,000. That means net to net you claimed 6,000. You understand? Sir, देखो ये जो net बचा जो ineligible है D1 D2 that we have to add it to output test liability. This also student don't understand. Why are we adding to output test liability? Because you claim 100%. अभी reverse करना है ना? How do we reverse? IT से reverse करने का एक ही तरीका है. Add it to your output test liability. तुमको समझा?
Yes,
sure. पक्का T1 T2 T3 ये सब समझ में आया?
Yes,
no doubt. Okay. इसके ऊपर एक question है करें? एक तो अभी किया हमने कौन सा किया 19 वाला क्वेश्चन था ना 4000 करोड़ टर्नओवर टैक्सेबल एंड 1000 सॉरी 4 करोड़ टैक्सेबल 1 करोड़ एग्जेम्प्टेड और कॉमन कितना था 20000 का इनपुट कॉमन था ये फार्मूला दिख रहा है आपको 20000 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 1 करोड़ डिवाइड बाय 5 करोड़ आ गया वो 4000 इनएलिजिबल उतना ऐड कर देंगे मेरे आउटपुट टैक्स लायबिलिटी में पक्का 19 वाला क्वेश्चन हो गया इतना नल्ला क्वेश्चन आने वाला है No talent required to solve that kind of question. ये formula भी नहीं पता था आपको, okay? इसका ही थोड़ा higher version पढ़ते, पढ़े? हाँ, ऐसे ने एक लौटा example दिया है. किधर है ये रूल नंबर 42 ये रहा नहीं ये सेक्शन 42 है शायद पेज नंबर किसी को मिला क्या रूल नंबर 42 का सिक्स पॉइंट वन नाइन पे एक हवाई चप्पल करके क्वेश्चन है उसके आजू बाजू में हाँ ये एग्जाम्पल देखो ये दिस इज हिडन एग्जाम्पल इन योर बुक 6.26 पे है दिस इज हिडन दिस लाइक यूजुअली एग्जाम्पल्स आर गिवन इन डिफरेंट कलर दिस इज लिटल हिडन राइट ओनली इंटेलिजेंट स्टूडेंट शुड फाइंड आउट दैट देयर पर्पज So this is example on how to arrive amount of common credit. Okay? Can I read this particular thing? Making an assumption that Hawaii sleepers are exempted. Take a case of easy footwear. So what is, who is your assessee? Easy footwear. And easy footwear is making some Hawaii chappal. Okay? To make it more practical, I would have taken chappals in my hand, but assume that there is a chappal in my hand. All right? I don't want to take actual chappals. So, chappals are exempt. Alright? Because chappals are used by lower sections of the society. They don't want to put tax on that. Manufacturer of two varieties of Hawaii slippers and five varieties of other sandals and shoes. So, there are two varieties of Hawaii chappals and five varieties of other shoes and other goods that they sandals they are making. Dyes are used in a manufacture of all footwear. You understand? Dye means that dye to cut the shape of the chappal and all that is dye that they put in machinery they are used for all footwears however bright pink is used okay different dyes are there to print your chappal however bright pink is used only for one of Hawaii variety and black is used for sandal and shoes so although all types of dyes are there black is exclusively used for sandal and shoes is taxable That means this is black is completely exclusively used for taxable goods and whereas this bright pink dye this color we are using exclusively in exempted you can assume about T1 T4 T2 is like this so this bright pink is T1 or T2 T2 exclusively exempt and this black is 100% hello 100% taxable that means T4 blue and yellow are used for all varieties Blue and yellow is used for all variety. This is C1. But this C1 we have to upload. This is common, no? Haan, this is common, but we have to derive common. How? Common, there is a formula for common. T minus T1, T2, T3. That will be C1. Okay? That we have to derive. Brown is used for non-business purpose. This is T1. This is T1. You understand? Brown is used for non-business purpose. Can we go ahead? Yeah. So from here we have to identify only T because C is the determination, mathematical determination. You cannot identify C in question. C is the determination. You have to identify what is total. Hello. What is total that is T and then you have to identify what is T1, T2 and T3. Here we don't have any T3 because there is no block as such. Alright, so T3 is 0, but T1 and T2 is there. Alright, if you subtract T minus T1, T2, T3, you will get C1. Okay, and that will be that common. What was the color, common color? Blue and yellow. Inward supply during the month. Now they are only, because this is example, no, this is not talent hunt. They are not checking your talent. They are trying to explain you how this works. Alright, so input on brown dye. Brown dye is 10,000. This is T1, non-business. They have written it. Input tax on bright pink, 90. This is T2, 100% exempted. Input tax on black dye. Black dye which was 100% in shoes, T4. Alright, and input tax on blue dye, 1 lakh. See, they have not defined anything to it. Blue is a common, no? That we will compute. Alright, and input tax on yellow dye. Here also they have not defined because these two are common. And total input is 2,55,000. Now what is the formula that we have to use? T minus T1, T2, T3. If you subtract from like 2,00,000, from 2,55,000, if you subtract these two numbers, which two numbers? 10,000 and 90,000. That means 1,00,000 you have to subtract. So you will get 2,00,000. 1,00,000. 1,55,000. That is C1. Okay. From C1 you subtract T4. Hello. From C1 you subtract T4. If you subtract like T4 from C1, you will get C2. C2 is equal to C1 minus T4. That is common credit. You understand? That is common credit. And that is, what is that? 1,15,000. 1,15,000. Now this common credit we have to apportion. First we have to determine common credit. Did you understand how to determine this common credit? 1,15,000. If you want tally, cross tally, I will show you. What was common? Only two, no? Yellow and blue. Blue is 1,00,000 and yellow is 15,000. We can directly also write, but we cannot write directly 1,15,000. You understand? There is a mathematical way, you have to follow that mathematical way. Understood? So 1,15,000 is the common credit. Now this common credit we have to apportion between. Hello, what happened? Something I just did.